top 10 anime with an overpowered main character feared by everyone. Hello and welcome back to The Genius. Today we'll be talking about the 10 main characters who are so overpowered that everyone, and not just their enemies, can't help but be a little bit afraid. These 10 individuals are people you definitely pray that they are on your side in a battle. Before we continue, if you like these type of videos, don't forget to like and click the subscribe button along with the bell icon to be notified the next time we drop a crushing top 10 list. Also, make sure to tell us in the comments below what type of top 10 video you would like us to make next. And now, without keeping you any longer, let's get into it. Number 10, Nagisa Shiota. Nagisa from Assassination Classroom starts out as someone his classmates consider to be a shy and very reserved person, especially in comparison to his other schoolmates. Nagisa even admits that he feels invisible and at first sees it as a downside. However, it's much more overpowered than he can ever imagine. The talent to become invisible in any situation mixed with his natural talent to assassinate makes him the ultimate potential weapon. When Nagisa gets zoned into an opponent, he uses these skills to take them down with ease. His other classmates and even his teachers are afraid of him in these moments, seeing him as the unbeatable assassin and top of his class. Plus, he can take a beating and still kick butt afterwards. Seriously, Nagisa can be quite scary when he tries to be. Number 9, Ragna. Ragna, the Blood Edge from BlazBlue Alter Memory, takes the next spot with his countless abilities and power. To start off, this SS class rebel is able to single-handedly take down entire squadrons of the Control Organization by himself. Keep in mind that these are well-trained individuals that are part of a military. Remember that Ragna is more or less self-taught when it comes to using his weapons and having any sense of a fighting style. This main character has a bunch of other abilities that I haven't even begun to mention, so let's get into those. Ragna is able to manipulate darkness, use his Soul Eater ability to absorb an opponent's life force to heal himself, and can use what he calls Blood Cane to enhance his strength. So if he wasn't already overpowered, he can make himself even more overpowered. The only downside to Blood Cane is that it makes him drain his health, but he later gets a cure for that in an advanced form called Blood Cane Idea. This guy literally seems to have no actual weaknesses. Talk about OP. Number 8, Manji. Next on the list we have Manji the Immortal. This guy is literally immortal due to a worm-like creature called Kessenchu in his body. This might make it sound like he deserves the number 1 spot, but there are quite a few weaknesses to his immortality. After all, immortal doesn't mean invulnerable. These weaknesses include burning to ash, extreme damage to bodily organs, being deprived of food and oxygen, and drowning. That being said, he has other abilities as well. He is an expert swordsman, a weapon master, and has very high intelligence. This makes him a very overpowered and scary main character. Number 7, Tatsumi Oga. Tatsumi Oga, a first-year student at Ishiyama High, is one of several delinquents in the student body. He finds a man floating down a river one day while he's doing laundry. The man splits in half, revealing a baby inside. The baby turns out to be the Demon Prince, and Oga is meant to raise him. Oga himself is a strong fighter, able to beat up the toughest of classmates to make them bow down to him. Even teachers are afraid of what Tatsumi Oga can do. He is strong, arrogant, and has no moral compass when it comes to other humans. This makes him perfect for raising the future Demon King, and also a perfect candidate for this list. Number 6, Tanya. Coming in at number 6, we have Tanya the Evil. For those of you who haven't seen the anime and don't mind light spoilers, Tanya was a middle-aged man in her past life. He or she had a disgusting and rude personality that led to his ultimate demise. After his death, he was reincarnated to Tanya by a god that he refuses to believe in. At 13 years old, Tanya had insane powers and strength that led her to fight and easily climb through the ranks of the country's army. Several subordinates and enemies fear her and constantly say so. It's definitely not hard to see why once you see her fight. She seriously got a lot of skill and pent-up aggression inside such a small body. Number 5. Light Yagami. Considered unconventionally overpowered, we have Light Yagami from the anime Death Note. While not strong or fast like other entries on the list, Light is incredibly intelligent. That isn't to say intelligence is the only fiat for the anime, as he also has the ability to kill anyone by knowing their name and face. He does this by writing their name in the Death Note. He begins to kill off multiple criminals and a few innocents along the way, earning him the name Kira. Although not intentionally feared by his family, friends, and colleagues, they all fear Kira and what he could do to them at any time. Light is methodical, logical, and cold-hearted, making him overpowered and completely terrifying. Number 4. Rei Ogami. Rei Ogami is the protagonist of anime Codebreaker, but it would be a stretch to call him a hero. This character here would be characterized as an anti-hero. He has a strong desire to uphold and serve justice, repeatedly stating the phrase an eye for an eye, a tooth for a tooth, and evil for evil. Some might know that as the Code of Hammurabi, which is the ideal that Ogami lives by. Because of this ideal, he uses his power to cause anything he touches to combust into flames, incinerating villains and people who break the law or hurt others. On top of this, he has a list of special techniques as well as being a skilled swordsman to pad his already overpowered resume. It doesn't take long for many in this anime to start fearing him for his powers and the reason he uses them. Some see his acts as uncaring, albeit logical, others think that he may have a heart in there, but find his sense of justice to overrule them. Either way, his mindset, mixed with his set of powers, makes for a scary dude. Number 3. Aynes Ulgon. Taking the third spot in the top 3, we have a man that goes by many names. Satoru Suzuki, also known as Aynes Ulgon or Momonga, finds out that their favorite massive multiplayer online RPG called Yggdrasil is being shut down and decides to stay logged in until the servers are officially shut down. However, once the time comes for the server to shut down, he becomes trapped in the game as his avatar. This one is pretty obvious on this list because everyone in this virtual reality is pretty scared of Aynes Ulgon. He's literally set on world domination to try and make everyone equal, whether they be human or not. A noble cause, but having that much power still makes people fear you. Number 2. Naruto Uzumaki. An old anime, but a classic one nonetheless. Which is why it is taking number 2 on our spot today. Now this is going to apply more to the original Naruto, but we do see traces of it carried to Naruto Shippuden, and even Boruto to some extent. We start with Naruto Uzumaki as a baby, where he literally gets the definition of overpowered sealed right into his body by his own parents. The overpowered thing in question being the nine-tailed fox demon, Kurama. Naruto's parents die, and he's left as an orphan alone in the village of the Hidden Leaves. People shun him, shame him, talk behind his back, and fear him openly. This leads to Naruto being sad and alone for most of his childhood life, due to that fear. However, as time progresses, the blind fear from the villagers fades, but we're left with the fear from his enemies. Naruto is reckless, but holds incredible power that later helps him defeat S-rank criminals like the Akatsuki and even a literal goddess later on. Naruto has always struck fear in people and left his friends thankful that they're on his side. Number 1. Yu Otosaka. Coming in first on this list is Yu Otosaka from the anime Charlotte. Yu is narcissistic and rude to everyone he meets once he realizes how powerful he is. His power is that he can take over another person's body for 5 seconds, which allows him to steal their ability, intelligence, or memory. This makes him pretty OP for his world. If you still don't think so, at one point, he takes the ability to go back in time and prevent death by stealing the power to stop death. It might sound confusing, but it's not hard to understand how powerful this ability can be. Due to this, he is feared by many classmates and people who know him. They're nervous, if not fully scared, that he'll take over their bodies as he has done so multiple times without anyone knowing. Imagine someone taking over your body, even for 5 seconds. Imagine what they could do. You too might find yourself scared of that constant possibility, right? Well, that's all for this one. are there any other characters out there that you think are more overpowered than the ones we have in our list? Make sure to tell us in the comments below. In fact, give us your own personal top 10 list, and if there's enough suggestions, we might just make a part 2 of it. Lastly, be sure to like and subscribe and smash that bell icon to get notified the next time we drop a new video. That's all for this video. Have a great day and see you in the next one, fellow geniuses.